stars, also wie die zusammenpasst, auf mit, weil eigentlich so die Welt sind, weil was kommt between release management and QA. Release management actually to QA is getting the patches in a good state. In an acceptable state, whereas release management is releasing acceptable packages. It sounds a bit different, but in the end, in my experience, it's just two different ways to look at the same thing. So that's one of the most important things I learned. And actually, if you look at the release team members, all of them are very active in QA also. And more or less, we consider it as of now as a blatant choice of the release team to be able to do QA work, or to be able to maintain uploads, whatever, because you need to know more than just your own package. So that's a common thing, and that's why also, in my opinion, the release and QA we should talk a bit about what we do in release and also what we plan to implement for the next version for Edge. So So if you look back, what has happened well and not so well, we see a lot of things where we could improve, I think. Of course, we see a lot of things that happened well, but that's more for the talk with more audience, where we say how good we are. Now we say where can we improve more. So, one thing is that was not working as well, I start now to memorize and set things, so I start to the end of all these process. But it's food and requires the extra 4 thing. So now I'm done. That's good. Now let's see if I'm able to get to my slides. Sometimes you see rolling problems might help.
Problems will solve themselves if you ignore them for long enough.
Yeah, but sometimes it's getting worse than this. I have very much experience with that.
That was not long enough.
Yeah, if you ignore some problems long enough that everybody leaves, he has not to worry about this stuff anymore. You ignore different problems and you get no users.
Hey! Now we come and hope to see some slides.
Yeah, we also have a broken line in the
room.
Pardon?
Yeah. Don't help me, I'm not only to have one of the X developers.
Same method.
I don't mind. We will just wait until all my things come up. So we see the next one.
I know that we have here my last laptop did the same one and just got off.
So, do one of you know offhand how to make full screen mode?
I think GV.
I know for XPDF.
Yes.
Yes?
Yeah,
XPDF doesn't have
full screen
mode.
Yeah. That's full screen.
Now let's see if it's there. And it's QA. Yeah, there's something like that. Yes, that's something I installed from Soul actually. Oh, I think XPDF. Yeah, there. So now I say it's here. So, okay, now to my first slide. That's what I already said. So the next slide is what worked. Now I have something I can look up. So that's good.
No, you should look on the screen, not at the bed.
Yes, problem is I can't manage both skins currently, so I have to
focus on it.
Sorry. So what went well in my opinion is of course the installer. That was really very good. We had a lot of good management tools, bug smashing tools, what's a bit more important for QA of course, is this partial fix was at least 3 first base packages and then the rest. Of course the base fix was way too long. I think there's no disagreement about that fact. But in the end, it worked out rather fine. Yes, yeah, so we sent out these updates that they were announced. Was, I think, very good. So even if you didn't know the things already, this time lapse, if on day N we will do that, and then we can do a day N plus these days, that allowed us to start planning even for time when we didn't know when the infrastructure will be ready. So the management was fine. One thing that is definitely important QA thing is the NMU policy. in the basically for more than half a year, and the new policy was if it's broken, upload a fixed version now. Which is not was the official in the new policy before was if it and then you need to be upload delayed at least to delayed 7 or even delayed 4 plus 14 days. And for a very long time you work with if it's too broken, you can just upload it to unchecked so that it can be installed on the same day. And that's something we need to consider if you want to new policy we want to continue. Of course, some SC bug fixes were still uploaded to delayed plus 7 because the uploader said, well, I'm a bit more careful, so I'm checking the bug fixes and maintaining some more time. But most SC bug fixes are actually so simple, you just should upload them. And that is actually what we are currently doing for the C++ API transition. I personally think we should go to a more aggressive and a new policy. Of course, it doesn't mean just upload anything you just like, but if it's broken, the maintainer ignores the brokenness, it should be able to fix it, and not you don't have to wait for the maintainer's own personal good mood to do it. And also what worked well, at least my opinion of course, is the managing the release in large. That of course starts at the time where I looked first into the release team, it's the first release announcement where at a time where I even was not a developer, so I don't want to comment about the December 2003 announcement. A lot of things where Debian at large would help us more. That is lead our, basically it's lead our release announcement. And don't upload things that are not meant for releasing. And take a look what the transitions are. So transitions are one of the software I will come back later on, because that's something having very much to do with QA. A lot of more things could have done better. What I want to highlight from these things is this, what we need to reconcile is, should we also release some development packages earlier? I can put all the slides in the web if you want. Because, for example, somebody managed to upload a CDBS fix to unstable just 5 days before the release, which rendered some packages depending on CDBS until then. Very, very done, I would say. Well, CDBS is now a CBUG anyway, so. But it was not too good. So that's it. And a lot of small stuff where the security situation wasn't happy at all. But, so some further improvement, what we want to do in Edge is we want to do a time-based release in December 2006. We have said we want not so much, we don't want to make as many release blockers as before, only again a small subset, and the rest of the important thing is more the QA-like approach. We want to do it, but if we don't manage to finish it, it's still okay. We can live with that. What we definitely want to do is we want less dependencies between libraries and agent bumps. That makes life hard for the release team because it breaks testing decision. It makes also life hard for the security team. Those of you who were here during the security discussion previously, remember that we said, oh, it's really bad if a new upload of Mozilla breaks a newer version of Mozilla breaks plugins, which if you update 7, it breaks Galleon and so on. So that's something which you should do as QA. Of course, we want to do less pain with some Arch, but there's now a good hope, in my opinion, good hope on the way, because for example, M68K performs now better than it before, and M68K is really an example that one can motivate the Arch people to do their own QA on the Arch architecture. That's not something that should be left to the QA team, but to the porters. Yes. And lots of more small things that we want to do. Of course, there's some ongoing QA, what has happened already in before the release of Sarge, which should happen now, it is happening now. That's Rincian, very helpful tool for us, because it highlights just the normal errors maintainers quite often do. Packages need to be buildable in testing and in unstable. That sounds very easy, but this is quite often broken. sometimes later. And this is ongoing QA works that patches are built in pbuilder, and if it doesn't build anymore, cbugs are filed. That helps very much. Something else that should be done by the maintainers actually is just check the upload before they put it on FTP master. Bug splashing is just normal QA work, but it helps very much for the release process. There won't be a release if there wouldn't be bug splashing parties. So that's very, very, very well. And more guidelines for developers, I think that is something, QA shouldn't just say, we have a package and we apply some guidelines, but we should really say, how can we help the maintainers to make this thing better? Because it scales better, so it's more fun for all of us, and it's just better in my opinion. There's something new QA stuff that we want to do. We want to work on this library manifest stuff. Steve is doing some work on it. Library manifest stuff has two things in mind. One is to know better which stuff in the library is actually used. And the other is, and make sure that the library is a simple version in mind. That's something that would help in a lot of different places. Second one is, you want to get rid of at least some of the statically compiled libraries. We know, for example, that zlib is statically compiled not only in such things like OpenOffice or dpkg, but a lot of other packages, and most are even unknown. So that's something typically created to say, you want to know where it's in and then fix it. And the next question is, is it possible to install a package on the move that we're in? There's Leaf is doing some work on the PO part. There's work going on. And the last item, what's in my opinion quite important, is this ugly Python policy to change it. Because it's broken if we have more than two different versions of Python in a stable release. The same is of course true for other things like more than two different versions of new TLS or our five different versions of the Berkeley database or similar things. It's all a painful, not only for the release team, for the QA. And that are still things that are where we didn't know the release meeting says we want to have them. But we are well, last year doing by release policy only. But the first we are really first goal is QA work, and if we either think up already the release critical bugs, but we just don't notice it because we don't check for it. Or we will say we start first with QA, and if in the end we say there are only a few left, it will become the list. So what we want to do better at edge, that means like at the release, we want to check the installer's release data release before we publish it. I think we all learned that lesson very hard. That's not possible you can do work as carefully as you want, but you should really do a check with the final version, or not what you estimate the final version will look like of it at this time. Also, this is the final release from the final official Archive state, not from the official Archive state where somebody just replaced some release files by hand and forgot some of them. That was very unhappy. And of course, the release notes should start earlier. Advanced a lot of stuff on the release notes. And one of the things that we started with is to say we have now a pseudo package for the release notes. So if anybody makes a change, it should be reflected in Edge release notes. Please file a bug now so you won't forget. That's something that's simple. Simple, but it will definitely help very much.
I already put a bug.
I've seen it. Yes, I decided to make a bug and so you were faster than me. So you see, we can learn, and this is one of the important of QA is to get experience, to learn experience, to put experience for other people. That's one of the important things. So there are now some slides about how QA and release interacts with each other. I think if there are some questions, I'm happy to answer them, to discuss them. I think you have the first question. Do you want to ask a question?
A few slides before.
Which slide do you want?
The first slide with the negative points.
Now let's see how we can go back. Yes. Is this one or the other one?
The other one.
No, the other one.
That one?
Yep. The point was don't update packages not for the next stable release to unstable. So that means, I saw some packages currently in unstable, which have a series of wave bug, which just says don't put this package into stable.
Yeah.
For example, TMDA.
Yes. Well,
or there was another package I can't remember. And does that mean that such packages go back to experimental?
Well, I think the answer is a bit more difficult. Well, if you have a package that sets a leaf of the package tree, I don't mind at all. If they are not testing their leaf packages, I don't really care. But I care, for example, if you have some not so leaf package called, for example, KDE. Then we say you want to release this version 3.2, and 2 days before the TIFF transition happens, or even 1 day before, the maintainer uploads the first part of KDE
16.
The maintainer at that time. Then I really want to emphasize the KDE team has improved very, very much. At that time, I said KDE sucks so much, but Gnome is good. But now I want to say, now we have a very good KDE maintainer, our maintainer team, and I'm really happy with KDE now.
And Gnome sucks.
Well, but at that time, it's such a thing. Really, well, if he says, well, yeah, it's probably not the direct command for start. I will now upload it to answer because understand anyways.
It was an incredible mess.
Yes. So, yes. That is not acceptable. Of course, if it's a police package, so I don't mind.
Okay. I think the answer to the question is a little bit somewhere else. The RC bugs on the packages are on packages that are not in testing and will not be in released at all. And that point is about packages that will be released, but where the maintainer, in the meantime, starts an upload for
Plus
One.
I see.
And that's that.
Yeah, yeah, right, of course.
So it's more about don't upload new releases than don't upload packages.
Yes, and of course, right. Slides are always too short.
It's okay. The answer, I misunderstood it a little bit.
but I have hopes to remember when it was next time such slides to write better. Because I misunderstanding should be.
But I got my answer.
But the slides are in the web, so. Yeah?
I have a question about the test process you intend to impose on the CD images build for the next release. I am a little bit concerned that checks being done on the CD images, which is the very last thing before a release, may be done as sloppy as they were done this time. Do you
no, no, so the issue is there were no checks this time.
And do you plan to have automatic checks on the CD images?
The problem this time was something else. The problem is that. Oh well, what happened this time? I think I should really say the full timeline of how the release happened. So the release happened that on someone on a Saturday morning, or Saturday midday, about last there was an extra deinstall which was not pushed to the mirrors, just to allow the last RC bug fixes to flow in from the build demons and some hand-built packages even from the to flow in, since there was an extra build demon. Since there was a normal deinstall run in the evening, and after that deinstall run, the mirror team started, well, the CD image team took the last mirror run, replaced by hand some parts of on the mirror says the release file which tells which release it is, so they replaced all the release files, but not the binary release files, started to build CD images from it. So the CD images installed successfully, of course. But they had the wrong security line. Because the security line was at that time checked out via if there's somewhere testing it, we go to testing. And actually, perhaps the best idea would have been to just commit something like 4 weeks before the release or 2 months before the release that the security line says the word SARS security. So there wouldn't be any issue. But after the fact, always needs to say what would have been better. So, in that time, there was no released version of that event to check against. And on the next day, with the install, the symbols was changed. So, actually, the releasing was not duplicated, most by the mirrors team, not also by the CD image team, as the other one, the real one. And for the next time, the plan basically, or my idea is basically, there are different opinions, of course, but the recent opinion more or less boils down to we will do, if it makes the last final written run, then we will restrict the air sync from FTP master so that nobody can sync from FTP master anymore, even not the top level leaders. Then we change the sim link, makes no release, and a very few selected people can air sync them from FTP master. So these people have the official things, and the official things is the DM which will be built. And a bunch of people who are usually doing a lot of creators say, okay, please you install a computer, you install a computer, you install a computer. And then we take about not only something like, well, actually we had something a few hours to check the CDs. We hope to make something like a few days to check those CDs. So we had too much further in the last days. If you want to add something on your point.
Well, another point is, well, we talked about Debian CD earlier, and Debian CD has a lot of places where you need to configure things to use the proper archive to set things correctly. And there were just a couple of very, very minor mistakes made at that time because of time pressure. And Debian CD will be rewritten before Edge release, so that should make it a lot easier. Another thing is that we will probably switch to using the proper release names instead of the code names. We will use the code names instead of the phase names. And that will also get rid of these problems, because the installer will then just put in Sarge in the testing in the security line instead of stable or testing.
Right. I would, however, still suggest that there would be to prepare and keep current a kind of checklist to be done, a list of checks to be done against CD images, so
yes,
that there can be really real test cycles for the CD run, so that
definitely
it would be very nice to only hit a single button to build the CDs after the
But the CD team is working on that.
Okay.
Well, we'll make much more checklists. There's a lot of mistakes one can make. But one shouldn't do the same mistake twice. Or list up just every mistake. The check next time you don't do the mistake.
No, I was going to ask out of curiosity if you know how the CD, Debian CD rewriting is going, because, well, we should keep an eye on that so that it doesn't become the edge blocker.
just send a mail to the Debian CD list and Steve McIntyre will probably give you an answer. But he really presented his plans at DevConf quite extensively. There were a couple of sessions held about it, and well, he even intends to go so far as to rewrite the CD writing tools, because there's this stupid licensing issue with them currently, and we have this crazy upstreaming maintainer for them, I believe.
but actually, what we also list, of course, are doing it. So it will be someday before the list, we'll say, okay, all tools that are not done by now can't be done. So we will take care of that. But yeah, and well, of course, the plans that I just said, Mark, is one downside. That means that between the day where we make the last Windows quarter run and the public release, there won't be deinstallers anymore. That means 1 week without deinstall. I can simply survive.
I saw there will be a week of limbo.
Yeah, I think that what was just described is very important, because the release so far has been mirror-centric, if you like. And we should go to a more overall approach where you take both mirrors and CDs and the release notes and everything else that goes with release into account.
Yes, there was the pressure that you change the sampling, it is released, CDs, we need CDs.
Same thing for setting up the security infrastructure properly within the time frame. You also have the time to do that. Same thing for maybe even do last minute changes to the Bootstrap and make sure that the new testing is supported instead of having complete inability to install testing.
Yeah, and so on. I see a lot of small things that we can do better, but for that, it really needs to say, okay, we have now 1 week or whatever time to make the final small adjustments. But I know that at least one of the FTP masters very much just like, well, this is a dynamic push, so it's simply that CDs can be built when CDs are built. They are disagree. But that will be some discussions we definitely are going to have. One FTP master thinks, has said, well, if the image building doesn't work in time, we just publish a sibling and we are done. Which is something I personally very much disagree with.
So, what about just setting the sibling and then wait for a week for fixes to come and you can still push
The
stuff into the.
The problem is that you should look at the
Then declare the release without
the sibling is in place. Some people.
As soon as the sibling is published.
Yeah,
that's important thing. So, what we intend to do is we put something in place, but only allow selected developers who we are sure that they won't leak it out to access it.
Maybe you can leak it out as long as the end user doesn't see it.
Then
no one actually gets it. So maybe allow everyone to see the released version and you just say maybe we are going to do changes.
On Monday morning, when this announcement on Monday afternoon, he said, but this time we are going to Monday evening. At this time we are going to push everything. But actually, on Monday morning, one IP address of CD images, which is normally not published, everything was open for CD images. And on Monday morning, the madness broke out, which mirrors have already half or full uploaded CDs, and people started to put less CDs and are fully in place. Because it was slashed out within something like 15 minutes. We can't do it. Either we hide completely or we are the least. At the moment when the sibling is visible to the public, Devin has the least. There's no way around it.
No, you can have one mirror that will get the news stuff first.
And no public mirrors,
you get
let me make my point. You don't promise that it's the final thing. You say, this is our release candidate.
But people are not going to listen.
People don't listen.
Mirror, you get a slash this story.
But not even that, I know what
you're saying. But that's part of the release story.
Sorry.
You have a release candidate?
No,
My
definite experience is what will happen. If you put it on, even on a validating place, if it's somehow available to the public, so first, when it will not only be slash-shotted, there will be definitely some mirror operators who will just use their network mirror, say ftp.country.org, and pull from that mirror because it's more current. And then, we can't do it. It's basically a no-op for me. That's nothing.
Imagine that point. If you make part of the normal release process, so it will just be like the current testing or edge or whatever it's called,
and
people don't rush for that.
It's
the release.
No, but
what happens if there's an important problem with that? And people have installed it, and you cannot provide a backup to the final release. You're going to hit decent shit.
One thing that's really important is, what we are doing in testing is that we freeze or whatever so people can test. But what we really need, we don't need an almost release thing, we need a full release thing for the last test cycle. And we need to be able to repeat this last test cycle with full release stuff as often until we say now it's really final and nothing changes. So we need a full release thing, and the full release thing looks so full release that if people start installing it, then they complain at us that it's not fully released, that simply perhaps something is broken. And I can remember on the other day of the release, where all people did up a bunch of peer on Debian boot and Debian demanded, so the CD image is only half of that mirror, can you please fix it? Which was before the release announcement. I can, and basically, my experience there's no way on earth we can do it if somebody else, also a very small circle, sees it. Yeah.
Why? Just like a dam breaking, you can't stop it.
Yeah.
I just wanted to add the same thing you are pointing on at the moment. You are painting to the wall. Happened to FreeBSD about 2 or 3 times.
You mean to early release or what?
They pushed the release up to the mirrors without having the announcement out. And 15 minutes later, it's on Slashdot, and the people are starting downloading it. And the previous people had big problems to say, we haven't done any release announcement as long as this hasn't happened. This is not the release.
Yeah.
They just didn't manage it. The only thing they managed is to, second or third time it happened. They managed to get Slashdot that far that they didn't bring that stories.
Yes.
but that was the only point.
Well, actually, what our plan was with Sarge, which happened out quite well, I would say, was we made, definitely the works, top level mirror pushes to some manufacturing mirror in the US and Europe and in Asia, and then push further. And we know that the mirror push, the important part of the mirror push takes about 1 hour till it is visible on the mirrors. So we said, okay, we will send out the release announcement about 1.5 hours after the push is started by hand. That was a reasonable time plan because it was very early things, the assembly was just moved to the end and normal and so on. But that was reasonable, I think, yes.
One question. When the CDs are tested and the mirror pulls ready, I believe that the images have to be built in each principal mirror, right? With
No. The images are for the D images. We have 2 things for the D images. One is we have the chip to find, it's rather small, and we have the CD images. And the CD image network is under very strict most part of the CD image network, the important parts, are under very tough control of the CD image host. So what they said was they even could do if they know long enough in advance, they could push images and hide them from everybody but themselves. So they are in the middle, they just need to be moved. And then we need to say, at this time, you see we are going to publish, and there is somebody logging in to each host and makes this move in the host. And then it's public.
And each mirror will have to do that.
Yes, and about, they're speaking about $10.
The CDs and the JPEG files are, the CD images and the JPEG files are actually produced at almost the same time. There's no time lag in that. The only thing that lags behind is the torrents.
But I thought that each principal mirror, instead of syncing the images, pull the JITO files and build the images, you know.
I remember
the Spanish mirror, and I would have to ask.
Well, it's just one thing, it's just one day the JITO files actually moved, because the first rebuild happened in a not so good connected site. So at that site, the images are built, the JITO files are generated, the JITO files are synced to the CD image that will work. There, the JITO files are produced with the CD images, and the CD images from there are pushed.
But that's something that the
D images of people are very, very helpful. And if we say with enough time in advance, we will make this release process, they will be able to contribute to us. Okay, something else I would like to go on to spend some time on is about this whole library and transition stuff. One thing that is really very painful for us currently is the transition of different libraries, for example, the libcheck one. So they made a library bump from the SO name of 0.80 to 0.100. The old package was removed at that time, but about 30 to 40 of those packages are depending on that package, and that means that all of these packages need to be fixed at the same time to go into testing. And this is not only true for that, but even worse, if there's for some reason there needs to be, for example, implement a new action version into a stable later on to cause some bug fix, all of these packages need to be rebuilt in stable, which is really painful. So for testing, there's some easy idea to how to solve it. That is just to keep the old binary-only packages in testing as long as necessary. I've seen it. As long as necessary. until all packages disappear, but for stable you can't do that, so...
Stable?
For stable. How does it work for stable? If, for example, for an... Well, this is a... libcheck is an easy one, but say, for example, libkylo is going to... It's the same type as libkylo, where KDE and GNOME all depends on... And yeah, then says and there are some security bug fix, they release a new libkylo to fix it.
That bumps the same name?
Yes, yes, it bumps also.
The interface?
And that's something which would really hit us very bad.
Yeah, but it would be even worse if you would have a security issue in C that would bump the. As a
C compiler.
It's not only about bumping the. No. In which one, libgcc or what?
Yeah.
Libgcc. It won't hurt us because libgcc, I can still I can take a bucket from potato and run it against libgcc.
Not necessarily.
Not the other way around. I can't take a bucket from Sarge and run it about potatoes libgcc.
From my number.
Yes, but the other way around, that's something like API compatibility, thanks to library versioning.
But the possibility of a security fix needing to break forward compatibility, it's something like highly unlikely.
You mean like Mozilla?
It does happen in the kernel.
Eh?
It does happen in the kernel.
It has happened.
Yeah, but I mean, in a number, well, the number of reverse dependencies is huge.
Yeah, well, I don't think we need to come to a level of conclusion here, but I think that's something that we need to keep in mind.
Okay.
Something like that, yes. Okay, so any more questions about there?
Would it be possible to make it easier for developers to see what packages are involved in major transitions that are going on at the moment? Because I know the information is available, but it's not very accessible.
Actually, kernel is so bad that even I wish I would know better which packages are involved. It's really bad kernel because the C++ API transition is so large.
Mm-hmm.
That's really bad.
It should be that high.
And for example, I don't know how many people really know that the upload of the next KDE version is tied into the C++ API transition. Which is, of course, it's technically okay. But it makes it hard for outsiders to understand what is going on there.
Well, developers or users or
both.
Well, for users, we send out mails. Explain what is happening.
Well, for users, we say it's unstable. But
one of these users suggested that there could be an announcement list for unstable users that could get this sort of stuff.
There is such a list. It's called Dev Developer Announce.
No. I'm going to send a mail to DDAs with the user details about the transition. Like, if you disagree, you will have to remove some packages. So you
right.
But I think there should maybe be a page where you have these transitions are currently identified by the release team and are being tracked. We want to move them to testing.
Yeah.
So we don't want new uploads.
Right. A page that
you
will give
a
package.
You have a field where you can enter your package name.
Right.
And you can see, okay, is this package affected by the transition?
Yeah, but for an old package it's quite easy to know. I mean,
yeah, that's very easy.
Just
yes.
The reverse dependency.
Yes,
you have to do a huge reverse dependency check.
Depends on
your package, of course.
When Peter.
Technically
speaking, you are right, but I think from the user point of view, that one is much better.
Yeah,
of course,
even from the developer point of view, I just discovered that one of my packages was actually containing some C++ files, which I had actually forgotten. So,
you could even do it like this, that if you have that code available, you could make a check in upload processing. And say, sorry, this package is not allowed at this point because of transition going on.
That's a cool idea. I think I know some people if the FTP master role who likes another sanity check.
Yeah,
but it's really a cool idea to make such a page. Okay, I'm now told that I So thanks for all.
Thank you.